Hello and good afternoon to everyone that's currently tuned in live with us on another episode of Phillip Trading Podcast. I'm your host for today and my name is Trent. With me here today is my colleague, William, a senior marketing executive from Phillip Futures. How are you today, William?
Very good, thank you. Yourself?
Yeah, I'm good too. Good to hear that from you. In this podcast, we will be talking about the trading themes for this week and also share how traders can position themselves for the week. So I would like the help of all beloved audience today to share this video to all your friends. The more people that are watching this video, the more we are motivated to deliver greater content to all of you. So without further ado, let's jump into our topic for today. So today we'll be discussing on the topic, have technology stocks on Nasdaq losses in glory? If you have any question, you can message in the comment box below. So technology stocks on Nasdaq undergo a deep correction since 2 weeks ago. So William, from your point of view, what are the main reasons that have caused the drop in the prices of technology stocks on Nasdaq?
My own view, I think there are two main reasons that really causes the pullback on Nasdaq stocks. The first one would be due to the high valuation. So I think we all agree that technology stocks are currently trading at historical new high valuation. And I think this is also one of the reasons that fund managers are switching some of their portfolio to recovery stocks where the value of it has been dampened over the year. So, and the economy has reopened. So I guess this is one of the reasons of portfolio rebalancing. Okay, so they are going to earn some money from the recovery stocks. This is one of the reasons. And the second reason, I reckon, is the main reason, which is the entire world are actually very worried that how inflation going to play in a short period. Because as we all know that the commodity prices has been going up really steeply, and this is really crazy, okay? And the increase in commodity prices has actually led to very high inflation. So when inflation is high, usually how we measure inflation is by looking at the consumer price index. Consumer, the CPI is actually one of the indicator, very important indicator to measure inflation. So when we see the inflation is going up, okay, very high, which means that the Fed, everyone is expecting the Fed, the Fed in the US to will try to press the inflation down by increasing the interest rate. Okay, so when the Fed decide to increase the interest rate, basically the money that the fund manager or the money that the hot money that has been invested over the world, okay, in the stock market tend to pull out and return back to the US. So this is one of the uncertainties. And like I have shared in our previous episode, okay, market in general, we hate uncertainty. So when there are uncertainties, market tends to get very volatile. So in short, I think these are the two reasons that really cause the Nasdaq stocks to have this kind of deep correction.
Yes, I agree with you. So basically, the high valuation of the technology companies and also the worries on inflation certainly have raised concerns among the investors. So for our next question, based on your opinion, will Nasdaq continue to go higher in 2021? And why do you think so?
I reckon that it's quite likely. I won't say guarantee 100% that it's going to happen in 2021. But I think it's very likely for Nasdaq to continue to break new high. Okay, if you look at the Nasdaq indexes price movement, okay, historically, usually the sell-off or any panic sell-off, it happens in a very short period of time. And the bull can last for months, 3 months, 6 months, 9 months before another correction or before another panic sell-off. So this is the action or the nature of Nasdaq or all the entire US indexes. So at the moment, Dow Jones and S&P 500 indexes has already break new high, okay? And these three indexes, Nasdaq, S&P, and Dow Jones, they are usually like brothers, you know? So usually they tend to move in the same direction. If Dow Jones and S&P has break new high and continue to go higher, it's very unlikely for Nasdaq alone to go into a downtrend. So in general, I reckon that, yeah, they tend to move in the same direction. So if you, and also now move to the second part, we talk about fundamental. So just now it's about technical point of view. So every deep correction, it tends to be a very short period of time and rebound is going to last for months. Now move into fundamental. So the fundamental of Nasdaq related stocks, if you really understand, they are all technology. So the future prospects of the Nasdaq related stocks are actually really great. Okay, and a lot of them are actually, we call them the disruptive companies, which means they dominate the market sector in their category. Okay, so the rule of thumb for all these fund managers to invest is always to invest in stocks that can continue to grow. Okay, this is rule number one. So for me, I reckon that once this recovery or banking stocks have reached their fair value, okay, which is, I don't think it's going to be very far away, okay? The most, I think, is another 30%, I guess. So once that the recovery stocks or the banking stocks has reached the fair value, the hot money will eventually flow back to stocks that can grow, which is listed on the Nasdaq, okay? So yeah, I reckon that it's very likely for Nasdaq to continue to go higher this year, actually, 2021.
Yeah, there are certainly a lot of promising factors for Nasdaq to break higher. So let's see how how far can Nasdaq go this year. So for our next question, I reckon many of our audiences will be interested to know, which technology companies would you recommend to investors?
Okay, so to answer this question, I think a lot of people are still not familiar with US stocks, okay? A lot of people, they are not familiar. So if you are a newbie that wanted to get started in the US stocks, I reckon you can always look at the big cap, which is the FANG stock, FANG, which are Facebook, Amazon, Apple, Microsoft, and Google. I think these five companies are one of the very good place for you to start, okay? Because the services that they provide and the product that they provide are part of our life. So it's very easy for us to firstly understand the business model. Second, they are kind of like the disruptive companies that I mentioned earlier. They dominate the market. They are the leader of their own sector. Okay. So I guess the risks involved are always lower, because if there is a dip, usually like I mentioned earlier on the Nasdaq, the dip will be very short period and the rebound is going to last for months and it's going to be very strong. Okay. So other than the big five cap on Nasdaq, investors should also pay a very close attention to the semiconductor giant, like the TSM, the Taiwan Semiconductor, okay? The NVIDIA, the AMD, all these are very worth your attention, because I reckon that the demand on semiconductor is going to go up tremendously in the next 5 years, okay? So other than semicon, the disruptive companies, I think the EV related, the electric vehicles like Tesla, NIO, definitely is going to benefit from the latest government policy in China, in Europe, in US. Okay, I kind of share my view when we discuss about the copper, about the future prospect of copper. Okay, so China, Europe, and US, they all tend to once their country to fully go into EV cars, EV starting 2030. So there is just another 10 years to go. So I reckon that this kind of companies is going to really greatly benefit in the next 5 years.
Yes, the company that you mentioned are certainly some great companies for investors to look at. So to our audience who are interested to invest in any of the companies mentioned by William, you can actually assess them through Phillip CFD platform. Also, currently we are having a promotion for US share CFD, of which investor can enjoy low commission and participate in a lucky draw to win Apple iPad, Apple Watch, and Apple AirPods. For more details, you can drop us a message on Facebook and our representative will get back to you. Lastly, before we end the podcast for today, one last question for you, William. After discussing the potential opportunities, what are the potential risks that could negatively affect the technology stocks on Nasdaq?
Okay, I try to break this part into two parts, okay? One is on long term and the second part is on short term. I'll start with the long term. So in longer term, the biggest risk that could impact the technology stock is when we don't see growth in technology companies anymore. This, I personally reckon that is quite unlikely, because we are now in a revolution era. So our world is moving from 4G into a 5G. That is a revolution, a very big revolution. So all the big boys automotive companies around the world are currently heavy invested in the research and development on the EV and also on the autopilot system. So in less than 10 years, EV is going to take over the ICE car, which is the internal combustion vehicle, the diesel vehicle. all over the world. So yeah, I reckon it's quite unlikely for technology stock not to grow in the next 10 years. Now, moving into the shorter term, I reckon that the biggest risk that we all need to keep an eye is that when Fed decided to increase their interest rate, when they see the inflation or the recovery has reached a certain benchmark, okay? So this is really something that we all need to keep an eye, because like I mentioned earlier, the moment that the Fed decide to increase their interest rate, okay, all the money around the world is going to pull out from the stock market and go back to the US. So this is definitely going to cause a shaky market lah. Yeah. I reckon, yeah, I hope that answers your question.
Yeah, definitely. So let's hopefully it will not be so soon for the Federal Reserve to increase interest rate. And now we have come to an end for today's podcast. To our audience out there, if you have any question or any topics you want us to discuss next week, you can message in the comment box below. So thank you for listening to our podcast and happy trading for the week. Thank you for your time too, William.
See you, Trent. See you next week. Bye-bye.
Yeah, see you. Bye-bye.